Hi, I'm Ben Marriott. I make weekly motion design tutorials, and this week I'm going to talk through how I used mats and textures to create all the effects in that animation. Let's begin. In this video, I'm going to show you how using some simple effects and combining them with looping textures and mats in different ways can lead to some really cool results. Now, this piece was made with three layers of composition. This main layer here, which combines the face and the helmet's comp. The helmet's comp, which contains this section, which is pretty much the head, the sparkles, and the surrounding helmet area. Now, this head comp is where we've got the majority of our good animation stuff happening in here, so let's get stuck into this first. So I'm using the preserve underlying transparency, which is this column here, to restrict everything to this pill shape that we've got going on in the middle, which is the monkey's head. So this works a lot like a clipping mask in Illustrator. Now, at the very bottom, I've got this head shape layer, and I'm going to solo that by clicking here so we can only see that layer and so I can better explain what's going on. And above that, we have two visible layers. We have wave one and we have wave one shadow. Now, if we turn off our effect by clicking here, we can see that wave one is just simply a rectangle and all its movement is happening by using the wave warp effects here. If I switch off wave warp two, you can see that the first wave warp just gives this, you know, slight wave sort of moving in a position sort of effect. And wave two is applied to just give a little more distortion to that wave and let it seem a little more natural and more chaotic. Jake Bartlett has a fantastic tutorial where he goes in depth on how to really push these wave warp effects to create awesome smoke and hair and all sorts of things. And most importantly, I've got this preserve underlying transparency selected, which you'll see in this column here. And I ignored this for my first 3 years of using After Effects. And that means that this layer only appears over already visible areas. So in our case, it's our head layer. So it's kind of like an alpha mat for every layer that's underneath it. And if I turn it on and off, you can maybe get a clear idea of what's happening. And we've also got this wave shadow layer down here, which is an exact duplicate of this layer above. And we've just added a drop shadow effect and changed the blending mode to dissolve. If we switch it back to normal, this is what it looks like. We've got a nice smooth gradual gradient. But if we change the blending mode back to dissolve, we get this nice gritty grainy effect, similar to what I used in my grain shading tutorial. Now, I've also got a bunch of shied layers here, so let's unshy those and reveal them all. Now, let's select the visibility of wave 2 and wave 2 shadow by soloing them here, which are pretty much the same as this wave 1 and wave 1 shadow here, except we've got some different colors applied with some fill effects. This wavy bacon layer here is a video texture of these wavy lines looping in a sequence of four images of similar wavy lines. And I've used a tint effect here to map the black and white colors to these blue and pink colors that we've got in our color palette. And above that, we've got a wave two mat, which is essentially a duplicate of wave two, and I'm using that as an alpha mat. So this wavy bacon layer is using the preserve underlying transparencies so it doesn't appear outside of the pill shape. And we've got an alpha mat, which means it's only restricted to the shape of that wave layer two layer. Now, you could achieve this effect with a combination of alpha mats, set mats, and pre-comping, but I find this method keeps it just a little more tidy and intuitive to adjust. And above that, we've got another three layers of waves and textures that just fill up our monkey's head layer. Now, above that, we have these drippy comp layers. So let's add those and see what those look like. So inside this drippy one comp, here we've got this hatchy texture layer that's happening here. And at the bottom here, I'm using it as a luma mat inverted of this drip two movie that we've got. So here, this is just this dripping effect. And I made this by drawing it frame by frame on my iPad using the app Rough Animator, which I think at time of recording is the best animation app on the iPad. And after this drip animation finishes, I've got another copy of this hatchy pulse layer with no alpha mat selected. So that just takes up the whole screen. Now back in our monkey head layer, we can see that we've got this drippy one comp and we're using a luma mat for this composition called drip two mat. And inside this comp, we can see that we've got that same drip two movie file of this dripping animation. And I've just got it started a few seconds into the composition. So it's a little offset from our original drippy one composition. And that gives the appearance of a strip of that comp being visible and being erased by the same dripping animation coming up behind it. Now, that may make zero sense as I'm realizing I'm trying to explain it. So let me try and show what's going on. Without this track mat, we have this hatchy texture just rising up using this drip animation. And above that, we have the drip two mat. So as we make that visible and scrub through, we can see that that's the same drip animation coming upwards, but just a little bit behind. So when we select luma mat, we can see that it's slightly just following that dripping animation and removing it as it goes. and we go to a frame where we can see the start and the end of that drip animation. If we move this drip mat forward and backwards, you can see it reveals a bit more and a bit less. So if you want it really thin, you can leave it at this length. And if you want that sort of strip to be a lot thicker, you can pull this back a little. And then we've got the same thing happening with duplicate comps just above and offset a few frames, and then slightly colored differently. So we get sort of two sort of colors and waves of this matting dripping effect. And that repeats every few seconds with these other layers here. And I've got slightly different textures inside each of those. And at the very top of this comp, we have this head highlight and head shadow layer. And the head shadow layer is just a blue shape layer with a mask set to subtract and a feather set to 100 pixels. And also the blending mode is dissolve. So if we go to normal, we can just see that's, you know, just a feathered mask that we've got here. And set to the dissolve blending mode so we get this nice grain. Now you could also use a blur effect on the shape layer to get the same results of the feathering, but I prefer a feathered mask to blurring because dinosaurs had feathers and dinosaurs dictate most of my decisions. And then at the top, we've got this head highlight, which is essentially the same thing, but just with a lighter blue fill color on the top right here. Now let's navigate up to our helmet comp above this. So I'm gonna do that by pressing tab and clicking on this helmet composition on the left over here. And here we've got much fewer layers in this comp. At the bottom, we've got this helmet layer, which is a pink shape layer, just a circle. We've got the helmet shading layer, which is that same pink circle duplicated. I've added a fill effect of a darker pink and done the same feathered mask and dissolve blending mode as well. And then we've got these sparkle layers in red here, which is just this star shape that I've got three times, scaling up from 1 to 100. And then we've got our head comp here. And we've got preserve underlaying transparency, so it only takes up the area defined by the alpha channel of this circle layer here. Again, here you could use an alpha mat or a luma mat to achieve the same effect. Now back in our main comp, we've just got a few more layers. We've got the addition of our face composition here. And if we go inside, we can see we've just got some shape layers making up this face. The mouth has a bit of a subtle animation using the path property here. I think it just sort of changes shape ever so slightly. And we've also got these eyes scaling up as well. And we've got the blue one scaling up, and then the pink one scaling up a few frames after, and then repeating them both multiple times, so that we get this loop of the eyes expanding, like, consistently, infinitely from the center. Back in our main comp here, we've got this helmet shine layer, which uses our same masking dissolve feathered trick that we've done before, and we've got two adjustments layers here, which has got the posterized time effect with the frame rate set to 12.5 frames per second, which just gives it a bit more of a traditional hand animated look, as if it was animated on twos. So there's not as many frames and it doesn't look as super smooth as you get with the 25, 30, 60 frames per second animation. And I use 12.5 rather than 12 because 12.5 is the standard in Australia, but you can use 12 and it will pretty much have the same effect. And then we've got an adjustment layer up here with our favorite turbulent displace effect with the size down to 2 pixels. And that just gives a little bit of extra roughness around the edges here. If I zoom in and flick it on and off, you could see it goes from smooth to just a little bit rougher to give a bit of extra roughness to the edge of everything. And finally, and above everything, we've got this looping texture here, which just adds this sort of white speckled sort of dot grain to everything. And if we look inside, that's just 4 instances of this texture rotating and changing position. Now hopefully you can see how repeating some simple effects and then using mats in some interesting ways can create some really cool effects and drive a whole piece. Now as I said, the project is available for download down in the description. I've removed some of these textures that because I've bought them from a different source and I can't share those, but everything else is in there for you to look around and dissect. If you use anything that you've learned in this tutorial, please upload it and tag me at ben_married_ on Instagram so I can share it in my stories. I can't wait to see what you make. Please let me know down in the comments what else you'd like to see from this channel. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell icon, like, comment, share, and like, or you've already liked, like it again. Well, like it 3 times. Got to do it an odd number. I'll see you next week.